Oh, while I'm waiting for anybody to show up, I'm just going to do a little maintenance on this character before I hop back into the warrior storyline. Hey, KM, how you doing tonight? Or today. Time is a construct. It has no meaning. Oh, going back to college tomorrow. Fun, fun. You on campus or living off campus? Both present their own unique fun and frustrations.
Thank you.
Ah, that's nice. Kind of gives you your own space and, but still lets you, appreciate the college life.
You won't find a better bargain. Come back anytime.
Ooh, roommates are always fun. Don't mind me, I'm just popping a... stuff in my XP armor here. Oops. Miscounted. Armor inks.
What can I get for you?
Oh, jeweler, that's awesome. Sounds like a lot of fun. Okay, quick vote. Should I give him the redeemed Revan lightsaber? Or the exquisite lightsaber? Or the ornate lightsaber? I'm kind of leaning towards the Revan just because it's really cool. Well, I mean, we have time to decide. That's why I picked up the extra stuff here. Alright.
Come back anytime.
To Korriban, I guess. The ornate ones are cool too. For context, he's a very fancy Sith boy. And he just doesn't look as fancy right now because he's in his initiate clothes. Go to Hutta today. I do find it funny how, like, the knight gets to go to Ormantel for reasons. And yet neither, I think neither the warrior or the inquisitor, they're like, I'm not going to that stink pit, Hutta. Oh, the warrior does go to Hutta. Interesting. Well, granted, I have not really played, well, thank you for, giving me a level for coming here, game. That was great. I can't wait to see, how he goes to Hutta. I'm headcanning him as the kind of guy who, like, you know, he gets pedicures, and so he really doesn't want to go to a, you know, the stinky place with all the slime, swamp sludge. As I run around the halls with the Jedi tailing me. What do you want to talk to me about? If you're racist, I'm out of here.
So, yet another acolyte stands in the shadow of our academy. You must consider yourself privileged. Tell me, you who would be Sith, have you seen much of our civilization so far? Have you been awed by this world's power and glory?
Nah. All I've seen is dust and tombs. Not very impressive.
Then you have not been blinded by your master's claims. Korriban was wrought by the true-blooded Sith millennia ago. Our ancestors, a crimson race of conquerors, raised the statues around us. Over the eons, however, our people mingled with slaves. Now the red markings of true Sith are rare, and the purity of this planet is in question.
And what about me? Are you doubting my purity?
No, you are young. It is your masters who concern me. True purity and strength are carried in the blood.
I thought it was the old lady.
I worry that
our
blood is being diluted over generations. In the Emperor's name, I have come to learn whether the Academy's overseers are Sith or not. You will be my instrument.
Nah. You couldn't pay me enough.
You will regret this decision. I never forget a face.
In a few years you'll be dead. God, I'll be honest, I found playing an alien Sith so frustrating, it kind of actually completely zapped my fun from playing the Inquisitor storyline.
There, Tino. I believe that's the one.
Really? Alright. Hey, you!
Careful, Tino.
Come on, I'm antsy for some action. You there! Are you the big shot they're all talking about? The one who's been personally summoned by Darth Barriss himself?
News sure does travel fast.
Please pardon my over-eager friend. It's just that we've heard so much about you.
And we want to get in good with you.
Tino? What my blunt partner here means is that if you need anything or anyone, say, dealt with, we'd like you to consider us.
She's talking about Femrin. We'll kill him for you.
Sorry. I should have had Tino muzzled.
I like these people.
So,
you're funny.
What do you say? We know Femrin tried to have you killed. Would you like him eliminated?
Something like this would have to be handled delicately.
Of course. We completely understand.
You guys are going to get yourselves
killed.
There
are rules. Acolytes are not to openly kill one another. Everyone knows of your rivalry. If you kill him, the Lords will presume your guilt.
But if Vemrin croaks while you get an alibi, people might be suspicious, but they won't be able to pin it on you. See?
I'm not interested. Sorry.
Let us prove ourselves to you. Spar with us. Then decide if we have the skills to benefit you in this endeavor.
All right. Let's see what you've got.
At your best, boys. It's time to audition for the big show. Took all four of us apart. This changes everything. From what I hear, Benrin's every bit your physical equal. If we can't even hold up sparring against you, we'll never be able to kill him.
I agree. You should steer clear of Benrin.
Well, this has been quite the sobering experience. Thanks for setting us straight.
I don't get it. Are we going to kill somebody or not?
No, Tino. And I think we ought to rethink this whole Sith training thing.
Good luck with that. They're not going to really let you off planet.
Most of you will not return from this endeavor. If you die, you will be forgotten. If you give up, you will be killed.
Cheery guy.
Now, out of my sight.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
You should. This is the end of the line for you, Clemeral. Just make sure you stay out of my way.
Look here, Vimran. I see the upstart, but no sign of Dolgus.
Clemeral, Vimran, you have been dismissed.
Yes, Master.
I underestimated you by sending Dolgus. It will not happen again.
Vimran, what happened to the rest of your hair?
Are you having trouble with Acolyte Vimran, supplicant?
If he insists on getting in my face like that, he's gonna have trouble with me.
He has been hardened into a lethal machine.
Sure.
Vimran has paid his dues. He's fought a deck stacked against him to get here. You, on the other hand. Let me get a closer look at you. Yes, as I suspected.
Started off practicing the saber swings.
Overseer Tremel has done you and this academy a great disservice.
Your warblade came early.
Prisoners flown in for your convenience. Even a beast here on Korriban instead of off-world in the wild. The pacing of the trials is deliberate. Only full immersion over time produces results. Your mind is soft, unhoned, undisciplined.
I'll remember that, and someday you'll regret those words.
I wouldn't regret destroying you where you stand. The first month of trials should be dedicated to philosophy, conceptual tactics, understanding of the Sith Code. Recite the Sith Code for me, Acolyte, and explain its meaning in battle, war, and politics.
What will make him the maddest? I think I'll go with 3.
The only code I need to know is kill or be killed.
Your ability is undeniable, but your readiness and your understanding of the Sith way is woefully lacking.
I should have bluffed.
I am your master now.
No, I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna bluff.
Most of you.
Sure, give me a minute. Well, you see, there's the dark side.
This is perfect.
The light side, and there you have it.
Pathetic. I can read the lie from a nascent Force user with my eyes closed. I am your master now. Tremel was becoming lax before you ever arrived. His unwillingness to adapt to the evolving Sith paradigm has become a liability. These are the actions of a traitor. Traitors are executed. I grant you immunity from punishment. Kill Tremel and bring back his hand as proof.
I do not like the idea of killing him, but I'll do it if I must.
I do not make requests, supplicant.
Oh,
now,
fuck
leave.
Off, Barriss.
I'm sure Tremel is still in his chambers. Don't return until you've killed him.
I know, like, the only thing that's gonna get me through this storyline is getting to snark at Barriss and piss him off as much as possible.
Feeling better?
I didn't expect to see you again so soon. Has Barriss sent you back to me?
I'm here to kill you.
Then I have been outplayed. Barriss has the authority, but I did not think he would do something this overt. Either I die, or he forces me to kill you, and to destroy my own plan. A master stroke. Very well, you have your orders, Acolyte. Know that it gives me no pleasure to kill you.
Hold on. It doesn't have to come to this, Tremel.
Do not hedge now. This is the way of the Sith. I'll try to make your end quick and painless. It's the least I can do.
It's like I thought there was a way out of this. I think maybe we have to fight him either way.
Your instincts are sharp, Overseer. Barriss ordered me to kill you.
Then I have been outplayed. Either I die... Very well.
Hold on.
Do not hedge now. This is the way of the Sith.
The way of the Sith is stupid,
I'll try to make your end quick and painless. It's the least I can do.
Okay, it's after the fight.
Now, I'm amazed. I knew you were strong in the Force, but not like this. You're more than ready to challenge Vemrin. Barriss won't be able to deny that now. He'll have the satisfaction of my death. But I die knowing my success. Go ahead. End this.
You're getting ahead of yourself. I only need your hand.
What? Wait. I think I understand. Barriss demands my hand. Proof of my death. I don't want your pity, Acolyte.
It's not pity. I don't want you to die.
I'm a credit to the dark side. My cause is just. You can see clearly, even if Barriss cannot. Take my hand. Well, that didn't tickle. I'll rest and then leave Korriban covertly.
Just be thankful you're not dead.
Of course. Goodbye, Acolyte. Rid the Sith of that plague, Vem. Now you hear... What?
That's the deal. Take it or leave it.
Oh, no. I'll be fine.
You'll get
what?
The outcome was most unfortunate.
Agreed. But as long as you live, there is hope. Cast Vemrin out, and the final triumph will be ours. Goodbye.
Right? Like, he's like, yes. You doing the light-sided choice that serves the dark side. Truly, you are a master planner.
Come here, child. Do you intend to explore the Academy? To know the world that gave birth to the Sith? You should linger here a while. I am Overseer Raggate. A keeper of the old ways. I sense you have potential, and I can help you if you like.
Everyone in the Academy seems to sense my potential.
But you have not yet come into your own. You have power and strength in the Force, but but you must be tested beyond the trials your masters have set for you. I administer the rite of blood and bone, a ritual performed beyond this doorway. It is a rite acolytes have participated in for 10,000 years.
I'm sure you were young and pretty back then.
Yes, I am shriveled. I am infirm. Yet, I survive. More than most Sith can say. Learn from my example. In the chambers, past the gateway, there is a colony of Shyrax, my leather-winged, razor-taloned children and their brood. They guard a mountain of skulls. An altar to the Academy's failures. You must reach the bones before proceeding.
I don't appreciate dramatic pauses.
Then I will continue. You must claim a skull from the mountain and return to the antechamber. Soak the skull in the blood pool.
This seems rather tedious.
Once bone has turned red, I will look and see your nature written in crimson stains. And possibly a glimpse of your future.
I think I'd rather have credits.
Ideal in ephemeral affairs, not credits. To complete the rite is to accept one's death, to steal one's own mortality. But it is also a trial of power, as are all Sith trials, a trial to test strength and to grant it. I will await you here. If you die, I will forget you.
Love you too. Yes, I want him to be a very snarky boy. Oh, I'm walking in blood. I'll never get the stains out. I do love that, like, one of them, like the equivalent of this over on the other side. It's like you're just, like, you know, doing your thing, and on this one you just scream at things. I am not in the correct area to use the blood, okay? You're a nasty-ass school lady.
I heard the screams of the Shyrax and the rippling of the blood pool. I heard the sounds of death. I know you brought the red-stained skull, and I must say, I am pleased.
That place was awful, even for Korriban, even for the Academy.
It is what it must be to test the hearts of Sith. The skull you carry, your rage, your actions drowned it with the dark side. It is part of you. I can read it. I can offer a small gift, but more than that, I can offer a glimpse of your destiny. There's much I can read in the bones.
Oh, I'm tempted to do three, but I'll go with two.
Who am I to turn down free advice?
Very well. Listen carefully. The key to your success is a small and sorry creature, but you can shape it in your image if you so desire.
That's not the outcome I expected.
That is all I see for certain. I can say no more. Prize what you have accomplished here. You are part of a tradition almost as old as Korriban itself.
So, is she talking about Vett or
Goodbye now, young Sith. This lesson is complete.
I'm gonna guess Jaysa because Jaysa is the one who has such a short way. Stark difference in personality. Shit. That was not the shortcut I wished to take.
I got your back.
At least someone does in this damn place.
I got your back.
What's this? The Acolyte returns, and with a bloodied weapon. I assume this means Tremel is no more.
Well, give me I did have head. To go to a blood pool. Thank you, him stories
this
might be
one
very
tight. Ring as a memento. Remembering the past can strengthen resolve and embolden the spirit. I am impressed you had the fortitude to destroy him. You know he thought of you as family. How did it feel to betray him?
Feel bad, man.
We worked closely together. It was quite difficult, Master.
Nothing worthwhile is ever easy. Remember that.
Oh my God.
You have taken your first step to understanding the Sith Code. Peace is a lie.
Your face is a lie.
There is only passion. Through passion, we gain strength. Through strength, we gain power. Through power, we gain victory, and through victory, our chains are broken. The Force shall set us free. By embracing the code and destroying Tremel, you have freed yourself from his shackles and escaped his fate.
And now I'm bound by your shackles.
You'll find they are a marked improvement.
Sure, buddy.
With much greater potential range. Now, there are sacred ruins in the tomb of Tulak Horde. The ancient inscriptions that once adorned the walls of each ruin lie in pieces. You will venture through the entire tomb, search all of the ruins, and bring me a shard from each of these inscriptions. You will do this, or you will die.
Yawn.
Vemran and my other acolytes have already been sent. There are no rules regarding how they secure the shards, and they will stop at nothing.
You know, this is a very inefficient
way. Fight your way through
way
the tomb of Tulak Horde in the Valley of the Dark Lords, and bring me the shards from each of the ruined shrines.
All right, let's see if this one looks pretty. Let's take what we got for now. Oh look, we have Tremel's ring to give to someone. Oh goody, I will save that for Vett. I'm sure she'll love the ring that is still on someone's hand. What a perfect way to ingratiate yourself to woman. Alright, sounds good. I'll be going for a little while here, although I'll have to stop around too, because I've got someone coming out to the house.
Come closer, Acolyte. The wind outside has torn my ears to tatters, and my eyes grow strained and bloody in the dark.
Well, that sounds really
unfortunate. I've studied this tomb for years, slept on its stones, and dreamed of its depths. Now, I need assistance to solve its final mystery.
Really? So are you mad or just obsessed?
Why should my sanity matter to you?
Fair enough.
This tomb is the final resting place of Tulak Horde. The tomb's maze was built to his precise specifications. But he built his maze to hold more than just his body. He built it to secure his greatest creation, his terrible machine, the Red Engine.
I really don't share your fascination with history.
Tulak Horde had power and knowledge unknown in this age. Surely that interests you. The machine was his life's work, a perfect puzzle that hid all his secrets. It was a vault and a library all at once.
Does this really look like
the scholars in the academy? They say the Red Engine was never completed. They say it never functioned. But I know how it works, and I know how to fuel it.
Then why not inform the scholars?
They think that I, not a Sith, nor an educated man, couldn't discover the truth. They ignore my findings and are blinded by arrogance. Listen now. Anyone can activate the Red Engine, but unless it receives its sacrifice, it will only sputter and die. The machine needs blood and hatred to become fully operational. If a Sith could slay the tomb's beast in its presence, their deaths would be its fuel. Find the machine within the tomb. Work its mechanisms. And when at last it reveals Tulak Horde's secrets, I beg of you, bring me its scripture. Bring me the knowledge I have dreamed of.
Unfortunately for you, the game really won't let me. I love how, like, everyone's ignoring me. Oh, bottle pet.
Those blasted mining droids were tougher than I thought. I'm not going to make it, but I hope whoever is watching this will honor me. Escaped slaves, stole weapons from the academy, fled into this tomb. They've reprogrammed the mining droids. Without those droids, the slaves won't survive. Tried to take them down myself. Didn't work out. Destroy enough rogue droids, and the slaves will die. Teach them not to cross the Sith.
Well, now I don't want to do that. As a person. I don't know if, not right now. Not right now. Large. I don't know why I forget that, like, but every time I'm just like, man, this place is big. I guess I should have kept that, heroic just for the, travel.
Feeling better?
help. I still got it. This will help.
My speeder pilot. There we go. Just a little bit faster. Shortcut. Onwards.
Good as new. Feeling better?
Let's go see what Baras wants from us.
This will help.
You did it, didn't you? You got the shards from the tomb, and you're on your way back to Lord Barriss.
Are you here to congratulate me?
I'll take that as a yes.
Whoa!
I got your back. It's not even a challenge.
Seriously, guys. You could have just asked.
Stop. I'm sorry. I made a mistake. I tried to get through the tomb, but there were just too many Chirac. I barely escaped. I figured better to ambush you and take your shards. But I see that's just as futile. Vemran is already inside with Barriss. All the other acolytes died. You were my only chance. Now, I'm doomed. I'll never become Sith. Unless I return with the shards, Barriss will have me killed.
Take my shards to Barriss as your own. I'll get more.
Really? You're giving me your shards? Thank you. What can I do to repay you?
Nothing. Just do me a favor and keep this between us.
Are you kidding?
He's a good boy.
I won't breathe a word.
You're probably gonna die.
Good luck going back
anyway,
into the tomb for another set of shards. I'll see you in Lord Barriss's chamber.
You could have a few extra, you know, minutes to breathe. I regret dropping my heroic transport now. Here, I'm gonna pretend to accept your quest real quick.
Come close.
Your name. Keep. What?
Feeling better?
How the shards just like magically refill themselves though. Deal with them. That's why she's here. You know, the fun thing about 7.0 was I'll get to completely swap over my Sith and just make them light-sided.
or help.
That was a race of rocket boots. Back again. I guess they say the dark side doesn't pay. I guess I could have told the guy to run. Probably would have been kinder to him over the long run. Is there a cantina in here? I should probably pick up that quick travel point if there is. There it is. I'm gonna go do that real quick. Especially if I'm going to have to be coming back and forth a lot.
Good as new.
There's no quick travel point in here. This truly is the worst place. Tython at least has a quick travel point, you assholes.
I accept all forms of currency.
Ugh. Jerks. Guess climbing
Thank
up the-
Thank you for your patronage.
Having to navigate that little pathway is part of your Sith trials. You get no quick travel point inside the temple. Quick travel is for losers and Jedi. Wasting your time climbing stairs is part of the ritual.
Feeling better?
Look who's here. I have nothing to say to you.
Good.
The prodigal supplicant returns. And with all the shards from the tomb of Tulak Horde.
Hi, Ark. Yeah, superb. I just decided to...
It appears Klemnol was right and you were wrong, Vemran.
Appearances can be deceptive.
Excuse, Vemran supplicant. He expected you to fall on your face.
Step by step, slay by slay, we're gonna be Sith one day. Yep. Yeah, I decided to just stream my new little Sith boy. Little Sith pretty boy here.
I have little to no interest in anything Vemran says or does, Master.
The tension is thick between you two. A great source of emotion to feed on. I wonder what will happen when
is
it boils
Barris
over.
Barris shipping us now?
But first, a matter to clear up. There is very little that escapes my scrutiny, and I know, Acolyte, that you provided Klemrel with his shards.
Shit, I should have told
So, since it was only by your tolerance that Klemrel stands before me, I leave his fate in your hands. What should I do with him?
He still managed to succeed. The directive was by any means necessary. That kind of resourcefulness should be rewarded.
Surviving this long is no small feat, so I agree that he should be allowed to live. But I do not find him to be Sith material. General, I'm assigning you to oversee the Academy prisons. It's not a glamorous post, but do your job and you'll be respected here. Report to Jailer Nash immediately.
It's something.
Thank you, my lord.
You're at least alive.
Thank you both.
We certainly lacks backbone, but perhaps he'll rise above that someday. Now, are the two of you ready for your final trial? You both stand on the precipice of becoming Sith. But only one of you will have the opportunity to claim a special lightsaber and serve as my apprentice.
Such a special lightsaber, too.
I thought it would be you, Vamran.
So pretty.
But I've changed my mind.
What? I've done everything you've asked. Better than any of the others. The honor should be mine.
Ignore Vemrin, Lord Barriss. His world is crumbling around him.
Today, Vemrin is every bit your equal. But the Force is stronger with you, Acolyte. And there is a power sleeping within you. It was a simple decision. Now, Vemrin, go wait in my antechamber for your instructions. This instant. Now, I hope you fathom how fortunate you are to be singled out. If you become my apprentice, the galaxy will bend before you.
Oh, sure. Yeah.
You're not going to regret this, Barriss. I was born to be Sith.
Yeah, good enough.
The lightsaber you will seek is old and powerful. It is housed in a forbidden cavern in the tomb of Nagasado, where few Sith have ever set foot. Almost no one knows how to find the secret entrance. But there is a Twi'lek in the holding pens who was caught breaking in there. I hear she is quite willful. Take her and make her show you the entrance to the forbidden cave.
That oh, no. Sounds like fun.
That's not what I wanted to choose at all. I misread that.
I have. You're not going to regret
the lightsaber. Almost no one knows how to. I hear she is.
You insult me, Barriss. I do not need the help of a slave.
You will not find the forbidden cave without her. Other acolytes seeking to complete their trials are sent to the tomb, where academy laws are waived. They will try to murder you.
Why?
This test will determine if you become Sith. So bolster yourself. To set foot in the tomb of Nagasadao is to breathe in death itself.
Guys are such edgelords.
Don't make me regret selecting you to get the special lightsaber. Retrieve the Twi'lek.
The so special lightsaber. Vimran wanted that special lightsaber. What do you want to bet, like, when we get the lightsaber, it's just gonna, like, have Korriban gift shop on it? You know, on the side. I was gonna say, we should go say hi to our friend! Maybe he's in the little zone here.
Give it a rest, will ya?
I'm getting my fill of fun while I still can, slave. Ah, as if on cue, look who's back. Word is you might become Lord Barriss's apprentice. Nice work if you can get it. Barriss supposedly sent me an acolyte named Clemrol. Some whiny little cast-off. But the deadbeat hasn't shown up. You know anything about him?
Clemrol means well, and he tries hard.
What he ought to do is try hard to be on time. So, I hear you'll be relieving me of this Twi'lek. She's a pain in the neck.
Ha! Who's a pain in the neck? I'm the one wearing a shock collar.
Consider that a going-away present, Twi'lek. Seems you might be useful for something after all. This bruiser is taking you into the tomb where we caught you.
None of you can figure out how to activate the tomb statues to open the Forbidden Cavern, huh? You got some kind of business in that secret Sith chamber, do you?
Yes, and I'd appreciate your help.
D- Don't bother being pleasant. Here, kid, take the shock control color. I'll set it to a high level. Use it enough, she'll show you the back door to her mother's house.
Is that a euphemism?
I suppose I can play tomb tour guide. A lot of work went into cracking that nut, but I did it once. I can do it again.
So we're clear. I'm officially on strike when it comes to domestic duties.
I promise you, I won't require a maid.
Well then, maybe things are looking up for me. As if they could get worse.
I mean, they could, but... Carl, the poor man.
Lead the way. I'll show you the unlocking point throughout the tomb, and then open the secret door for you. You're good to go.
I don't want to walk out the door. It's a long walk. And he's a lazy Sith boy. Edgemaster light beam. Projector power crystal not included, made in Nar Shaddaa. Yes. On the bright side, I'm leveling up like crazy. We should probably re-up this thing.
Nobody better mess with us now.
Acolyte, may I speak to you for a moment?
It depends.
I'm always willing to listen to a beautiful woman.
Oh, yes. Thank you. You're too kind, really. There was another acolyte, not long ago, who entered this tomb and did not come back. He died in there.
And you were worried to see a handsome man like me die too?
No, I mean, not that... But that's not what I meant. I mean, it's just that the acolyte who went in there, he was a good sort. Friendly and talkative. He said he was entering the tomb to prove himself to his father. I just thought it would be nice if somebody took his body back and told his father he didn't make it.
Yes, the father should be told that his son has fallen.
I'd never survive in there. And even if I did, I wouldn't be allowed to see his father. He is a Dark Honor Guard stationed in the Academy. None but Sith can ever set foot on the sacred ground where he stands watch. But you could find the body and bring it to his father. Please, do this and honor the fallen.
If I see the Acolyte's body, I will try to retrieve it.
Thank you so much. If you find the Acolyte's remains inside the tomb, let me know. I can tell you where to find his father in the Academy. Good luck.
Well, he is a sucker for a pretty face. I'm gonna carry this corpse around in my pocket for reasons.
Who reckons down your deadly Koshlegike, you may have made, yes?
What are you supposed to be? Why don't you start from the beginning? Tell me what happened next.
Yes, ясніших багалів, ніж я чесно рігаш.
If Prythor's the one who exiled you to these caves, I doubt he'll change his mind about feeding you.
Because Ketokash. Zvetir Kafargi Yesnik. Zutargeshimartoshi Lagyak.
There is strength and power within you. I'd like to know the source.
Kabyesh, Mechijet Herfrash, Yander Ekjegensim in the Jurkimata. Ha, Falkniger is the intrepid Yesa.
So, Rune, I am probably going to forget completely about you. And I apologize for that ahead of time. I don't even get it, like... I mean, other than me just yelling someone to death. Is it like, what is that power of yelling someone to death? Is it just complaining like a Karen? Until they just give up? Are we just asking to talk to their manager? Every time I do it. I asked for a soy latte.
Please use all products.
My latte isn't foamy enough for R. Yes. That too.
Be well.
Hey, this is it. The secret entrance to the hidden cavern is in here. Just let me get my bearings.
Dare you interfere? This business is far beyond you.
He saved my life. I'm not going to let you stab him in the back.
You have been most helpful.
It's the least I could do.
You should probably go.
The least you could do is die.
Hey. Oh no, did he hurt my friend?
The fool must have spotted me following you. Too bad his warning will do you no good. It ends now. Once I kill you, the slave girl will show me the Forbidden Cave, and I will claim the lightsaber and my rightful place as Lord Barriss's apprentice.
You'll do nothing of the sort. Fitting that you meet your end in a tomb, Vemran.
My passions run deeper than yours. I am the true essence of what it is to be Sith. My legacy has suffered long enough. After today, you will be forgotten. It ends here and now.
You killed my friend. Sure. I'm gonna yell at you.
All better.
Oh no. My power of complaining to the manager didn't take him down in one shot. Try it again.
Becoming Barriss's apprentice was my destiny. Did I come this far and overcome such adversity, only to be proven unworthy?
Don't be so hard on yourself, Vemran. You have been a worthy opponent.
Shut up! There is only victory or death. I refuse to live a lesser life. Finish me. I will not accept mercy. Die!
I thought we were going to just
let him. Nice work.
Long, weary monologues filled with inflated threats and subtlety of a drunken rancor. The true essence of Sith, yes.
Glad to impress you.
The secret entrance is right here. You're welcome.
That was impressive.
You have been most helpful.
It's nice to be acknowledged. Thanks.
These little lights on the side make me think they're little loot buttons. Comment about the statues, but I'll resist. Let's see the special lightsaber. I do like the reworked cinematics here.
Thank you.
Really? That's the special lightsaber? That face! Oh my god, that face! What the hell was that face, buddy? Oh, I insulted his lightsaber, now he's mad. Oh look, little brain boys. I don't want to use that special lightsaber. It's kind of ugly. How many brain boys are there? Come on! There's a much better way to spend the afterlife. Alright. Alright guys, okay, so time to pick our lightsaber. I have, let's see, we have the ornate lightsaber from this season. It's not bad. We have the exquisite lightsaber from this season. Also not bad. And then we have the Revan redeemed lightsaber. Which just has a very pretty color to it by default. I kind of lean towards this one. Alright, vote in chat. We gotta vote for Revan. That's right, I needed to go return things, didn't I? I forgot I was carrying that, her boyfriend's corpse. Alright, now here's your corpse, lady.
You found him. That poor acolyte.
He got torn up pretty badly in there.
He was so brave and ready to prove himself to his father. His father was Naaman Fall. As I said before, he's one of the Dark Honor Guards in the Academy. If you take the Acolyte's remains to his father, I'm sure he'll be grateful.
What exactly is a Dark Honor Guard, anyway?
I didn't really pay
they
attention.
They are the Sith, chosen from the most loyal and brutal shock troops, to defend the Dark Council and the Emperor himself. You can find the Acolyte's father outside the chamber of the Dark Council. That's where he stands guard.
No more flirts.
You should go. Talk to Naaman Fall.
Ah, yes, and our modification quest that you can literally only do on the starter planet. Bonus. I'll come back for him later. It's not like he's starving or anything.
Ugh. As places of higher learning go, this one has got to be the scariest.
It's not my favorite either. And I just like to keep Ferris waiting, so off we go. I guess that didn't want to come with us. Here's your
son's corpse.
You
don't belong here. You stand before the Chamber of the Dark Council, and this floor is off-limits to all who are not Lords of the Sith. If you are not on official business, you will leave now.
Wow, this looks like a nice place to hang out all day. How do I land your job?
You kill more people than you ever knew were alive, and when you are done, you... I sense. You are carrying my son's remains. He was such a weak boy. He shames me in death as he shamed me in life.
What a great
when
father.
When I heard of his death, I could not leave my post. Honor forbade it. Still, I would like to know what happened in there.
Yeah, why not?
Of course. Ask away, my lord.
Your deference does you credit. Now tell me, where did you find his body? Did my pathetic son even make it past the first steps? In the end, was he Sith?
He died valiantly, deep in the tombs. He was nearly Sith.
He died well. I suppose my son had more of me in his heart than I had ever considered possible. With this news, you have brought me a peace I didn't think possible.
Isn't peace a lie?
Thank you. I will have him buried in honor. Take this small token of my appreciation and go.
You're good to go.
Who needs to wait? I did. Me. I needed to wait. Well, I suppose I earned that. It's too bad all these conquest points I'm racking up are going to waste. That's like one of the most annoying things about Conquest Overhauls. If you roll up a new tune and get them into a guild, you basically have to wait until an entire week to play them. If you want it to actually count towards a conquest.
You,
I do know your
murderer.
Pain, Sandy.
My father was a staunch traditionalist, and he was especially hard on me. But he's my blood. Did you think you could kill him and get away with it?
Who told you I killed your father?
Everybody says so. The whole place knows you killed him. And now you have to die.
Well, I suppose the whole place can't be wrong.
You'll rue the day you took.
Alright, alright. I guess we'll...
You! My...
Who told you I...
Everybody says so. The whole place knows you killed him. And now you have to die.
Stand down, Eskella. Your father isn't dead.
That's a lie. Lord Barriss has his hand.
I mercifully took your father's hand instead of his life.
What? You took pity on him and now he pretends to be dead? You may not be a murderer, but your mercy proves you're not Sith material either. I should inform Lord Barriss, but I won't. No, let him discover your softness for himself. My directive is clear now. I must hunt down my gutless father and end his humiliation.
I'm not going to let you do...
They don't make this easy, do they?
Who told you I... Stand down.
What? You know...
Leave him alone, Eskella. Let your father live in peace.
My father has shamed me. Destroying him is the only way to redeem my name. I'll be sure to kiss him on the cheek for you. Come on, boys, let's go.
Well,
You!
Who told you?
Well, she's gonna be like that.
Everybody says so. The whole place knows you killed him. And now you have to die.
Well, I suppose the whole place can't be wrong.
You'll rue the day you took his life. Attack!
Well, if he's gonna be like that, then,
Nobody better mess with us now.
Well, there was no negotiating with you.
I am beside myself. Not only did you get the Twi'lek to cooperate, but you completed the task and claimed the ancient lightsaber. Vemran was not in my chamber as I instructed. I take it he sought to stop you and claim the ancient weapon as his own.
He tried and failed. Vemran was nothing if not consistent.
Bravo! I see you may indeed become one of the strongest Sith in the galaxy. Your trials are over. You are now my apprentice.
It took you long enough.
Mind your tone, my young initiate. This is only the beginning. With you as my right hand, we shall strike fear into the Empire's enemies.
I
must convene with the Emperor and inform him of your progress. This shuttle pass will take you to Dromund Kos. Meet me at the Citadel there.
As fond as I am of this unyielding planet, it will be a pleasure to leave.
You will find Dromund Kos to be considerably more stimulating.
Yay!
Take the Twi'lek slave as my gift. Do with her as you wish. If she'll be of use, by all means, take her with you to Dromund Kos.
Alright, let's see. Do any of these take off her slave collar? Well, that doesn't seem to have one on there. Nor does that one, or that one. Okay. I'll just take the virtual, just in case.
The shuttle to Dromund Kos will be leaving soon, Apprentice. I suggest you gather your slave, other belongings, and catch it.
I can get an Uber if I need to. Do any of these people's dirty work anymore. They're all assholes. Good riddance. Goodbye, Korriban. I will not miss you. Such a shame the Jedi are gonna come and blow this place up in a few years. Oh, whatever will we do? Oh, let's see. That civilian outfit, slicing outfit, or armored outfit. I guess we'll go slicing? Here you go, vet. Have some new digs. Anything to say to me yet? We'll go to the cantina area just to see. She does! Alright, well then let's go up to the VIP lounge. Oh, I needed to take off these. Ridiculous practice blades. I think we voted on the redeemed lightsaber, so. I don't need to get a lightsaber crisp, but I really like that color it came with. I wonder what anything is close to that. And let's get a matching one.
You're good to go.
I guess I can go buy more, mods. Oh, okay. Now let's see. Now that he's off Korriban, he can have some fancier clothes. Let's see. I think that's just a little too fancy. Too fancy. That's probably good enough. Way too fancy. And it still needs a dye. That one's nice too. I think that's a good apprentice outfit there. We'll go with that.
So, hey, I've been thinking, maybe you want to take this shock collar off? You know, as a sign of thanks for my hard work on Korriban. Not that I don't enjoy the perpetual fear of electrocution.
You've earned it, Vet. It is not freedom, though.
Wow. Now I feel stupid for not asking sooner. Don't worry. I'll try not to give you reason to slap that thing back on.
Neither the collar nor your slavery were my idea.
I hear you. Just another day in the life of the Empire, huh? Well, I'm not in prison or collared, and it's sort of miserable weather, so I guess we should... What happens now?
You and me, working together, taking down the galaxy. What do you think?
What? Well, of course. Me and my buddy, the Sith. Nobody's gonna pick on me at school. Sorry.
That.
Let's just get going, yeah?
She had him at chirp. Chirp, chirp, chirp. This, I think, is a good spot to leave off with him dancing beautifully here. As I need to go get some lunch. So, I might hop back on a little bit later. Thank you guys for coming out. If I hop on back later, just keep an eye on your Twitch notifications. Until then. Actually, let's see what he has to say when I say goodbye.
It's been a pleasure.
Oh, nice. Catch you guys later.